The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his namesake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Psalms 23. One of my favorite scriptures. God wanted me to talk to you today about valleys. He wanted me to let you know that just because you're inside of a valley, just because you're inside of a deep, dark valley of a shadow of death, and the shadow of death has been following you around, and people and places and situations have been trying to kill you and take you down and take your joy away and steal things out of your spirit and make you feel like everything is over and everything is despair, is a waste of time. It doesn't matter, because he leadeth you. In Psalm 73, it says, he leads me beside still waters, and he restores my soul. And he leads me down paths of righteousness for his namesake. So we got to be willing to go down a path of righteousness through a valley to get to a mountain that we have to speak to that's in our way. See, y'all got to get this. You got to understand that inside the valley, if you agree with what the devil has been telling you about your valley experience, then you stay in the valley. And God is not interested in you staying in the valley. He's interested in you going through the valley of the shadow of death to a mountain that you speak to, not that you claw at, not that you scratch at, not that you cuss at, not that you scream at, not that you yell at, not that you kick to try to get it to move. No, all you have to do is speak by faith to that mountain, whatever thing is standing in your way between you and your destiny. You speak to it, it's going to jump out of the way. But that's not going to happen until you find out what's in your valley that you need to pull out of your valley. See, there's certain things that you're going through in your life right now, and you can name it your valley of the shadow of death period of your life. It may be people in your life that are actually literally physically dying. It may be relationships around you that are dying. It may be financial situations in your life that are dying. It seems like things in your life are losing life. They're dying around you. It's the shadow of death creeping up behind you, and it almost seems like to a point where you're going to die. And the devil tried to come to you even at nighttime. I'm speaking to somebody right now. I don't know who I'm talking to. But the devil's been trying to make you think that you should take your life. The devil's been trying to tell you that your life is purposeless. It's meaningless. It has no purpose. You just go to work. It's null and void. Well, I'm going to tell you that the devil's a liar. Because he says he leads me to still waters. And when waters are still, that means it's peaceful. You see, just because you're in a valley, that doesn't mean still waters aren't there. When it rains, water comes down a mountaintop into a valley. Yes, it goes into the ground through the soil, but it wants you to dig a well where you are and dig for it. Just because God is silent at this time and you can't hear the voice of God, you don't know what he's saying about your life, that doesn't mean he doesn't have anything to say. That just means that he planted a word in your valley and he wants you to dig for it. It's something in your valley that he wants you to get out of it before you move on to your mountain. Because if you come to the mountain and you don't have enough bass in your voice, the mountain ain't gonna hear you and it ain't gonna move. In other words, if you ain't got no faith that you came, that came from a deep, dark valley period. See, what I'm saying is, look, you got to get to a point where I'm looking in my valley. Yes, I ain't got no money. Yes, it seems like I can't get my credit up. Yes, I'm still living at home. And yes, I ain't got no car. And I don't have this and I don't have that. And X, Y, Z, I don't have this and that. You know, the devil try to get you to focus on what you don't have. But what God is telling you is everything that you need to get to where you're supposed to go is already in you. Your problem is you keep looking on the outside for things. You're looking for other people to validate who you are. You're looking for other things to validate who you are. And God is giving you a divine identity. Your divine identity is what you use to go through the valley. You go through the valley with knowing who you are. Jesus went through a valley of his whole life knowing who he is. He had a relationship with the Father, which made him have a relationship with other people that was so supreme. It was so superb compared to anybody else around him. That's why everywhere he went, he was able to bring heaven to earth. It's not about us going to heaven. Yes, when we die, we're going to go to heaven, but it's not about that. It's about us bringing heaven to earth. Jesus was able to bring heaven to earth wherever he was because he knew who he was. When you know who you are, you don't have to focus on other people or other things to try to make you think who you are. Try to tell you who you are. See, the devil, he'll try to come along and tell you that based on what you've done and based on where you've been and who you've hung around in the past, that's who you are. The devil's a liar. That's not who you are. That's who you were. I'm telling you that by the blood of Jesus, everything that you used to be is dead and it's gone, is washed under the blood of Jesus. Now you walk through the valley, you blind, you can't see anything, but you can hear the voice of God. And when you can hear the voice of God, you can walk through the valley of the shadow of death with life on your tongue, and you speak life to your dead situations. You speak to the valley of dry bones of your finances. You speak to the valley of dry bones of your prayer life. You speak to the valley of dry bones of all your relationships. You speak to them. You speak to the mountains. Before you get to the mountains, before you get to those big things that are blocking your path, before you move forward, God is looking to cultivate a praise in you in the valley. There's something inside your valley that you have to realize is worth taking with you. See, a lot of us think, oh man, I can't wait to God bless me with this, or I can't wait to get to this point in my life. No, don't think of it like that. Take where you are, take your broke, busted down, beat up situation, take where you are, use it. If you can praise God now, if you can praise God from where you are, if you can see God from where you are, if you can look and see past the pages of the Bible from where you are in your life now, if you can just look down in your valley, if you can look inside of darkness and see light, if you can get food out of a bowl that's empty, I mean, if you can just walk when you don't have legs, you know? I'm talking about seeing when you don't have eyes, hearing when you don't have ears. If you can get to that point of being so blinded by the goodness of God and so deaf to the voice of the devil, so convicted and so wrapped up in the word of God, the truth and the simplicity of the gospel, that Jesus loves you and Jesus has your whole life in his hands. If you can get to that point, no matter where you are, I don't care what you're doing or what you've been through, if you can make your valley flood with the glory of God, with praises coming out your mouth, I guarantee you that mountains would jump out your way. Yeah. Mountains would jump out your way, meaning all of the large situations that you think is stopping you, all the big stuff that you think is stopping you, they literally would jump out your way. And then the divine connections and all the blessings of God and the divine people that he wants to put in your life, they'll jump in your path. It's your tongue. Your tongue decides what's in your path. Your tongue decides what's in your path. Yes, the devil will send things in your path, but your tongue decides how long you stand in front of that thing. Either gonna speak to it and tell it to die, because it has to listen to you, because you're a child of God. Either you're gonna speak to it and tell it to die, or you're gonna sit there and have a conversation with it, have dinner and lunch with it, you know, like we do all the time when negative thoughts come up. We sit there and have conversations with the negative thoughts, have conversations with the demonic. Or you can just immediately not tolerate it and tell it to die, tell it to move. And you keep moving forward. See, God is interested in you going through the valley. You're going to go through the valley. You're going to go through the valley of the shadow of death, because even Jesus did it. But he still moved forward. It says, the Bible says that Jesus was tempted with everything that's common to man. Everything that we ever attempted with, Jesus was tempted with it, but he went through it because he knew who he was. He was always in constant communication with his Father. So I'm just going here to tell you one more time. Take from your valley. Don't be so quick to try to get out your valley. No. When all hell is breaking loose, that's when you need to be taking notes. Because that's when God is speaking the most. That's when God is speaking the most, when all hell is breaking loose. Because when all hell is breaking loose, that means all heaven is coming as well. Y'all didn't get that. I hope you get that.